Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, Addie P's Real Estate Tea. Hope everyone is having an awesome day. Just wanted to pop on real quick, do a really quick video just to update everyone on the CDC federal moratorium and its extension. Now, if you like what you hear in this video, please graciously give me a thumbs up, as you also graciously always do. Also, subscribe to the channel. I have new content that is going to be coming out, and I want everyone to be able to see that and hopefully get something from that. And also hit the bell notification to be notified of future videos on this channel. And you already know, if you're watching your girl from Instagram, drop her a heart, show her some love. Alrighty. Now, we have all been kind of waiting around, as I had predicted, and what will continue to happen in my predictions, that as long as this virus continues to linger around and so forth, they're gonna keep kicking this can down the road with this moratorium. So basically at this point, it was scheduled to end, the moratorium was scheduled to end the end of this month, January 31st. Well, the CDC has extended that moratorium to now March 31st of this year. So you may as well say another month or two, 2 months technically, of this moratorium. And let's hope that during this time that these federal funds that are being sent to agencies across the U.S. to help combat any potential evictions or foreclosures is being allocated as it should. Now, I did put some information in the description box for you all. One of those pieces of information is the self-certification from the CDC. So if you are facing eviction due to non-payment, due to a possible job loss linked to coronavirus, whatever it may be, that self-certification, it should be given to your landlord, per CDC guidelines and so forth. So like I said, I did link all that information there. I also put some information for housing agencies, which I've put in other videos of mine, but I'll put it in this one. It's in this one again as well too. But needless to say, you'll want to reach out if you are facing eviction due to non-payment to any of these housing agencies that are allocating these funds and running these programs, so that way you can get your application in. Because a lot of times what happens is once funding runs out, that's it. Now, the funding that has been allocated in this particular round of stimulus that everyone has gotten or should be still getting, which they're still in talks and heavily leading towards us getting a third stimulus, it could be as early as February, or it can be as late as April, depending on how the discussions go in Congress and so forth, and if everybody's on the same page. But needless to say, there's still an issue as far as tenants not being able to pay, landlords subsequently falling behind on their bills as well too, and their mortgages. Now, just to tap onto forbearance a bit, if you have not already applied for forbearance, you want to definitely make sure that you do so, especially if you have a federally backed mortgage, something like a Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac. You want to make sure that you contact your loan servicer as soon as possible to make sure that you can sign up for that forbearance, because that forbearance lasts for 12 months in most cases. Now, if you do not have a federally backed loan, you'll definitely want to still contact your mortgage servicer, because there may be some options available to you that are specific to your particular mortgage servicer. So definitely check this out. It seems as if there are some options available. If you have already gotten to that point and you've already used your forbearance period, the 12 months and so forth, you still should reach out to your servicer to see what other options are available. I have linked my contact information in the description box. As I've mentioned in previous videos, I do negotiate short sales, and if anyone is finding that they are in that position, feel free to give me a call or email me, and we can definitely have a confidential conversation regarding your specific situation. All right, well, I hope that this information is helpful to you all. Please comment below if you want to see or hear of any other types of information. Otherwise, like I said, I do have that information for folks that may be looking. I know here on a local level, just recently, 9.1 million was allocated to PA to help with rental assistance and homeowner assistance. I do have some information that is below for the local agency here in Northampton County. And again, that HUD.gov, go on there. You can look to see what the housing agency is, and they should be able to tell you if they're running the program or direct you in the right direction for that information. All right, enough talk. You all, until the next time, have a blessed one. Take care.